And actually, this is one of the most historic meetings in all my 23 years as a freeholder slash commissioner. The votes we took tonight are going to transform county government as we know it. Not only did we pass a budget for the second year in a row of zero tax increase, but we voted to save $103 million over the next 5 years by closing the jail, the Union County Jail, and housing the prisoners who need incarceration in a neighboring county, saving millions and millions of taxpayer dollars. This really is a result of some visionary thinking on the part of our county manager, Ed Oatman. He has done a terrific job navigating this program to the point where we are tonight to vote on this. There was a lot of negotiation with our neighboring county. There's been a lot of consideration done on the employees and the corrections officers who work there. He's worked tirelessly to make sure as many and all of them that wanted an opportunity to work, either in Essex or even neighboring Hudson County, had that opportunity. It's been an extraordinary effort on his part. I want to thank Director Charles for his contribution to this effort. Sheriff Corbelli, who is has been really picking up a lot of work, and we'll see through moving forward to the proper running of the what's left of the Union County Jail. This is an amazing effort on behalf of this county. And the new building authorization is another significant thing that we did today. And the way we're able to close down all those leases, consolidate our operation, and come up with a much needed new facility for county administration and all the directors should not go unnoticed. And this is a tremendous effort that will bring good labor union jobs to the construction effort and the ongoing effort. So I'm just, overwhelmed by the magnitude of what we were able to accomplish tonight through a lot of hard work on this board's part and on the county manager part, the deputy county manager, all our directors. I'm just very thankful that we have such a teamwork effort of this kind, not only amongst commissioners, but amongst our staff. And all this being done in the middle of a pandemic that we cannot forget about. We haven't. We remind everyone wherever chance we get to continue to wear your mask, to socially distance, to wash your hands. As I believe Commissioner Staten mentioned, if you can get vaccinated, get vaccinated. We're going to be swiftly turning our attention to the reluctant part of our community, wherever they are, who are not going to be first in line for a vaccination. We have to then turn our attention to convincing them that that is the right thing to do and that we need them to do that. So I'll need everybody's help on this call, anybody listening to this, to help us persuade our neighbors who were reluctant for their own reasons. So we're going to shift our effort to that, and we'll be better off as a county, as a responsible for that. I'm just very thankful for this team, and I know that our future.